Hey, I was just in the Midwest visiting my family in Iowa, and they were talking about my recent trip to New York, and we were talking about the IPO process, and I realized that I wasn't actually like able to cogently explain all of the ins and outs and the whys and the hows. And so hopefully you can walk me through that, give me a couple talking points the next time I'm over there.
Well, yeah, so I mean, IPO is an abbreviation. It stands for initial public offering. So, you know, let's break that down. Initial, first time. Public refers to being a public company that's publicly traded on an exchange. And offering. And offering means you're offering a piece of the company exchange for money. It's a fundraising event.
So, like, how would you, you know, give an example of something that might require a fundraising event or an IPO?
Let's say, you know, your uncle owns a butcher shop in Des Moines, say. You know, if he may want to do a number of things. He may want to invest in that business and grow. He may want to expand it. You know, he may also just want to have a way to access some of the value that he's created for this business. And, you know, you can do that different ways. You can go to Yev, you know, to his nephew, his rich nephew Yev, and say, hey, can I have some money to expand my business? And that's great and all, but then how are you ever going to access, you know, the value as well? So what's great about being a public company is that it's a way to, you know, get money from the public. And get some liquidity for the founders, and maybe you don't want to sell the whole thing. You know, you just want to sell a piece of it. You still have control, but it's a way to usually it's just a fundraising event, and most often it's because people want to grow their business more.
Nice. And so the nice part is I'm not actually giving away like all of my business, right? I still have a portion of it. I just now have a little bit more money to do the expansion.
Right.
So like in monetary terms, let's say it's $1 million worth of a business.
Yeah. Yeah, so you'd say, you know, process usually is you hire some investment bankers, and they figure out what your company's worth. They do the analysis of the industry, look at your financial performance, and they look at other companies that are similarly situated and what they're valued. And so let's say, you know, to your point, they determine that this business is worth $1 million. So you may go out and say, okay, well, I'm going to raise, you know, I'm going to sell 10% of the company. I'm going to offer 10% of the company in this initial public offering, and that would be worth, you'd be raising $100,000 because it's 10% of $1 million. And so then you would have a stock that's publicly traded, and you'd have $100,000 in the bank to expand into, I don't know what other cities are in Iowa besides Des Moines, but, you know.
Iowa City.
Yeah, there you go.
So in our case, we decided to go public to raise some funds to really boost our B2 cloud storage, both the infrastructure and accelerate the growth there. And similar to the butcher shop, we decided to have this liquidity event so that we could offer up some of the company and take the proceeds and really expand the business.
Yeah, that's right. We wanted to put a little more wood behind the ball, so to speak.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much, James. And we'll see everyone next time on
Stocks and Storage.